So Julian White's the culprit this time. Now let's see. There it is on the paint. Oh, yes! Tenth try for the Irish captain. What a magnificent move! Straightforward set piece move off a great take of the line out. Let's have another look at this, and again and again and again. Up goes Galway this time. On the peel, Wood back.
Ireland played particularly well, but the significant moment in that game came when David Humphreys put a kick into the corner and Ireland forced the line out some 5 or 6 metres from the English line, and it was as nice a worked a tap move as you could possibly see. It was tapped down from Galway down to Foley, and Foley popped this little pass up and round like a bull-headed locomotive express came Keith Wood, and no Englishman, no 10 Englishmen were ever going to stop Ireland's captain. Big day for him, eclipsing Tom Kiernan's record as Irish captain, and also becoming Ireland's most capped hooker, taking over from Ken Kennedy in that particular respect. So it was a treble for Keith Wood.
The key to it was Anthony's pass. He popped the ball. I could have run any of 3 or 4 different lines, and the softness of the pass meant I could adjust before taking the ball, and it became an easy run over.
It's easy on the training pitch. We'll sell them these things about Cota on in an international arena, particularly against a side like England, but thankfully it did, and I think it set the tone for the game.
Watch for the softness of the hands of Anthony Foley. I mean, it's just, he gets the ball, that transfer is vital. It's not just there for dressing, it's there so that Keith Wood can take it at full tilt without breaking stride. And he almost lets it sit up in the air for like seems like an eternity. Just brilliant soft hands from Foley. He does so much that we don't see, that you've got to look at the video for Anthony Foley. He's one of the most selfless team players you'll ever see. But that was a little moment of pure class, because he is a footballer.